Hi, my name is Umar Qureshi and I love newcomers, especially romantic newcomers. And here's another pair, Hasleen Kaur, Miss India Earth 2011, and Shiv Darshan, son of Sunil Darshan. So coming together in a movie called Kar Le Pyar Kar Le. Welcome, guys.
Thank you so much.
I think Bollywood is the best space. Bollywood become more open now to new talent.
Right.
Producers, so directors are opening up and to experimenting with them. So just the fact that I can be on stage and perform. And
you know, usually my performances used to be in my bathroom. Because I don't know, subconsciously probably I wanted to perform, but you know, there was something stopping me.
Yeah.
So
definitely.
All my performances used to be reserved for the bathroom.
Yeah.
We've had a lot of brutal physical fights.
Yeah, because on screen he used to like twist my arm so much that it was, my entire arm was swollen, so I had to sort of tell him, okay, now you need to stop.
You know what she did? She punched me in my face.
Oh God.
And my face is swollen.
Never the face.
No, because he tends to use all his...
Actors, never the face.
But then I took my revenge after 2 weeks and I kind of unintentionally stepped on her toe.
Okay.
She was like, broke her nail and she was kind of bleeding.
Yeah, broke the entire nail. Just whacked it off.
Sorry, actually.
Are you dating anyone?
I am.
Yeah?
Yes, I am.
Are you?
I'm committed to my work.
Committed, he's dating his work. That's good. It's always good to meet newcomers. It's always great fun to interact with them and see them grow into mega stars, you know. So you tell me, since, you know, it's Sunil Darshan, his dad's movie, who has launched Lara Dutta and Priyanka Chopra in a movie, like the same movie, Andaz. Now he's launching another Miss India. So how does that feel and how did this break happen for you?
I think Sunil sir has this knack of finding people and for finding, you know, people that suit a particular role in a character really well. He's a visionary. He's been in the industry for 25 years now and he's given the biggest hits. So I feel privileged and honored that he's picked me out of the entire lot of talented people who come into Bombay. Today the influx is huge. But for him to sort of pick on me, and I believe they've been searching for almost a year before they finalized me. So I just walked into the office one fine day and within 10 minutes of chatting, there was no audition, nothing. And he said, okay, fine, let's sign the papers.
And it's a big deal because he's launching his son.
Yes. Yes, it's so much nicer to be with a fresh person.
So for you, you wanted to do movies always?
I always wanted to be a part of the Hindi film industry, but acting was not my first choice. That might sound like a cliche, but that's the truth.
Yeah.
Until this one particular incident that kind of took place, after which I said, yes, I want to pursue acting. What happened was my father was shooting for Talash, which had Akshay Kumar and Kareena Kapoor.
Yeah.
So Akshay ji could not make it on set. So my father kind of called me up and told me I need you to body double for Akshay.
Wow.
So I kind of went on set. My hair was chopped off because I had long hair. I wore his costume. They put makeup on my face. And I really, really, really enjoyed the entire experience. Although the shot was just like 2 seconds, I had to kind of walk and Kareena was kind of dancing in the foreground.
Yeah.
But I kind of really, really, really enjoyed those 2 seconds.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But
so
tell me,
I started pursuing acting from then.
Do you think it's easier for you because you are born into a Bollywood family and because your dad's such a well-known filmmaker, that is easier for you and others have to struggle a lot?
I personally feel it has its advantages and disadvantages.
Yeah.
Advantages being that, yes, you do get your break easily. Secondly, you're also exposed to a lot of cinema since a really young age. So you get the cinema education and the cinema grooming.
Right.
And the advantages would be that somewhere they kind of victimize you, I feel. You know, there's a perception that this guy is born with a silver spoon. This guy has it easy in life.
So, right. so they kind of prove.
Yeah, victimize you. But you know, having said this, it's eventually your ability, your ability to perform that's going to take you places here.
And eventually it's going to be decided in the dark room when the screen comes on.
Yeah, definitely.
But Hasleen, I mean, are you happy with your launch pad? I mean, you can be honest, in spite of Shiv sitting there, the producer's son.
Do you want me to go?
Yeah.
But in spite of you going, it's on national television, so I know.
Are you happy? I mean, do you think that Shiv got more attention because he's the filmmaker's son?
No, I think that wasn't the case at all. Sunil sir has made sure, he's made double sure that the attention is on both of us.
Mm-hmm.
Not just both of us, on everybody, because any interview that you see of his, he's talking about the actors, He's talking about the other artists in the film, the technicians, musicians, because this film has in a way become a launch pad for a lot of new talent. So Sir's Bay, Double Sure, I remember, I think I was the privileged one on set because Sir...
I was going to say that, to be honest with you. I felt she got the special treatment.
Yeah, Sir was being very particular about if I don't, you know, I need to be positive throughout because I need to perform, and I think... I'm quite happy. It was not. It was never Shiv getting more attention.
Did she act fresh? Since everything was fresh.
Sorry, act fresh. No, I think she was really good to work with. She was. She's really hardworking. She's really disciplined, and she's really supportive.
Yeah.
So it's actually like a boon to have her as my first actress.
Thank you.
Yeah.
And it's always memorable.
We belong to that.
Did he act fresh with you because spoiled brat, born into a film family?
I think Shiv is not at all a spoiled brat. Even though he plays this daredevil in the film, he's, I think, completely opposite. He's had to, I'm sure, work a lot to achieve Kabir's character. Because in real life, Shiv is like very calm. I don't know if inside he's sort of undergoing like this huge turmoil. I'm sure right now he's very nervous and stressed, but he doesn't show it. He's this very happy-go-lucky, very polite. He's very nice to everyone around him. His conduct is very good. I learned a lot from him because I was like all over the place when I started filming. But he's very disciplined. He keeps to himself as long as he needs to perform.
Shiv, was it different for you? You've grown up in a film family, surrounded by movie stars, you know, premieres, launches, parties. Huh? So was it different for you at school? How was it? Is it difficult for you?
At school?
At school, college, wherever, your neighborhood.
Not really. It was not difficult or anything. In fact, people used to I used to be like the center of attention because my father was a producer, my uncle was a director.
Yeah.
And people used to look forward for their movies.
Yeah.
And they used to always appreciate the music and all. And they always used to tell me, you're going to become an actor, you're going to become an actor. I'm like, no way, no acting for me. I'm happy, I want to be a part of this industry, but no acting for me for sure.
Were you spoiled?
Not really.
No. Extra
pocket
money.
I mean, I was the only child. I was pampered, given a lot of love, but I was not spoiled for sure. Yes.
But you didn't want to be a movie star, you said?
No, not initially. Not initially. Yeah.
Until you came in front of the lights.
Sorry?
Until you came in front of the
lights.
Yes.
Enjoyed the attention.
That was my claim to fame.
Yeah. And you always wanted to be an actress.
I've always loved being on stage, performing. I've loved being in front of the camera.
Yeah.
I think modeling came from that. And from modeling, I questioned myself, where from now?
Yeah.
Where from here? So I think Bollywood is the best space. Bollywood become more open now to new talent.
Right.
Producers, so directors are opening are opening up to experimenting with them. So just the fact that I can be on stage and perform, and
usually my performances used to be in my bathroom. Yes. I have this radio.
That sounds terrible, you know.
Sorry?
That sounds terrible.
No, but because I don't know, subconsciously probably I wanted to perform, but there was something stopping me.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
All my performances used to be reserved for the bathroom.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This sounds
just
loaded.
Just ready.
Come on, yeah. You're single, right?
Yeah.
You're single, or you're seeing someone?
I have many friends.
Okay.
Many friends?
Well,
you're not committed.
Sorry?
You're not committed.
I have got many friends who are girls.
Was your director happy with your Rajesh Pandey? Happy with your performance?
He is really, really, really happy. I've been I know Rajesh since 15 years. And he kind of helped us a lot, achieving this character.
Yeah.
Both are
I'd like to counter that.
Yeah.
I think Rajesh is never...
Okay.
I think because Rajesh is the kind of person who's not satisfied easily as a director, he's always pushing for more.
Yeah.
That's why we performed so well in the film. We've overstretched our limits. We've overstretched our emotions and how much we can give because of the fact that he always wanted that extra.
He's actually a hard taskmaster.
Yeah. He's a hard taskmaster.
But at the same time, he's really encouraging. He is happy with our performance, for sure.
Yeah. Yeah.
At least mine. I don't know about yours.
I don't know. I just feel he's constantly...
Who chose the story? Who chose the movie? Who chose the idea behind it? What is the story?
See, once I was back from training, my father asked me, what kind of cinema do you want to be a part of?
Right.
So I said the first movie that I want to do is I want to do a modern, contemporary, commercial flick. So he structured the story around that.
Yeah.
Kar Le Pyar Kar Le is actually an adrenaline gushing, action packed, edgy romantic movie.
Yeah.
It's like a wholesome entertainer. So he kind of structured a script around my want actually.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So it's tailor made for you. So it is you.
It's not tailor made for me. It's essentially that was something I told him, that let's not make a showreel, let's make a movie.
Right.
So he's like, cool, I'm like happy with that. And it's essentially a love story of two daredevils.
That's very Kabir well said. Everybody makes a showreel for their family. Yeah, well said. Yeah.
So it's essentially a love story of two daredevils, Kabir and Preet.
Hmm.
It's really edgy, really spunky. She's really feisty in the movie.
We're constantly daring each other throughout the film. We are like these two strong individuals with our own opinions who are like fighting with the world and fighting amongst themselves and with each other throughout the film.
Yeah.
And
physical fights?
But not on screen, off screen. We've had a lot of brutal physical fights.
Yeah, because on screen he used to like twist my arm so much that it was my arm was swollen, so I had to sort of tell him, okay, now you need to stop.
You know what she did? She punched me on my face.
Oh God.
And my face was swollen.
Never the face.
No, because he tends to use all his
actors, never the face.
But then I took my revenge after 2 weeks and I kind of unintentionally stepped on her toe.
Okay.
She was like broke her nail and she was kind of bleeding.
Yeah, broke the entire nail. Just whacked it off.
Sorry, actually.
You guys play a romantic couple, obviously, in the movie. But off-screen, were there any sparks, any romance?
See, to be honest with you, like, you know, bolte na, it's our first job. And not only our lives, but also other people's lives kind of depend on it. And so suppose there was no time for any romance or anything like that, because the stakes were so high. We had to kind of do rehearsals, we had to kind of dance, we had to
be so politically correct. Come on.
It's always good to be. I'll take you places.
I think both Shiv and I have tried to conduct ourselves very sincerely throughout the film and now post the film also.
Yeah.
I think both of us are very strong in the for our career.
Hmm.
We're very focused on our career. So I think it never has crossed either his mind or my mind to sort of do anything because I think in the film itself, the love story is so complicated and so huge. I think
No, but like, come on, you're single, right?
Yes.
You're single. Or you're seeing someone?
I have many friends.
Okay.
Many friends?
Well, you're not committed.
Sorry?
You're not committed.
No, I've got many friends who are girls. Yeah.
But you're not committed, right?
I'm committed to my work.
Ah,
I'm committed to cinema.
Yeah. You're not committed either. So what's to stop you?
Like I'm telling you, jaise aapka first job hai, stakes are so high. People are kind of, you know, not only your life, but the other people,
jinke
lives depend.
You can get to know each other better.
So
you can go out.
Matlab, aap romance karenge ya kaam karenge.
Yeah.
You know, that was the thing.
I just feel that I think as friends also, we kicked it off so beautifully from the beginning.
When was your first love?
My first love, I think when I was in third grade.
Yeah.
There was this one girl in school when I was like really young, maybe 4 years old or something.
Guys, I'm going to ask you some quick-fire questions now.
Oh my God.
To wrap up.
Okay. Yeah.
One Bollywood character you wish you could play if the film was being remade?
Mr. India.
Rani Mukherjee in black, I think.
Okay.
A superb role.
I have one more. Raju Gaid. I have one more. Satya Kaam.
There's no end to it. Such great characters
Dharam
in cinema.
Satya Kaam.
Yeah. Shiv's most annoying habit on the set?
He was way too quiet.
Yeah?
Way too quiet.
Annoying.
Always absorbed in his own thoughts and his calculations and his preparations.
And what's Hasleen's most annoying habit?
You know, she was so prim and perfect that she makes her co-star look really bad.
Both of you, love, money or stardom?
Money and stardom for me. Yeah.
Love.
If not an actor, what would you guys be?
I'd be running my own company, I think, doing something.
Yeah?
Yeah. I love ideating.
Yeah.
So maybe a brand agency, an advertising agency.
Great.
Maybe a technician in the Hindi film industry. Yeah. For sure.
Hasleen, one actress you look up to? Katrina Kaif, Kareena Kapoor, Deepika Padukone, Priyanka Chopra.
Deepika Padukone. I think she's done superbly well.
Shiv, one Bollywood actor you look up to? Amir Khan, Salman Khan, Shah Rukh Khan, Hrithik, Akshay Kumar.
Shah Rukh.
Any one actor you want to work with?
I'd like to work with all the Khans.
Yeah.
Amir Khan, Shah Rukh Khan, Salman Khan, Ranbir Kapoor, Abhi Deol, because I think his dimples are really cute.
Yeah.
And Nasiruddin Shah and maybe Amitabh Bachchan if I can. Wow. Add the...
Aur koi baki hai?
Koi baki hai?
Koi baki hai.
And you, any actress you specifically would like to work with?
I think all of them are doing a fabulous job. Yeah. And all of them are hot and I think they're really awesome.
Are you dating anyone?
I am.
Yeah?
Yes, I am.
Are you?
I'm committed to my work.
Committed. He's dating his work. That's good. One thing without which love is impossible.
I think faith. You need to have faith and trust in the person you love.
Faith and trust.
Yes.
Honesty.
Honest. Fantastic. Yeah. When was your first love?
My first love, I think when I was in third grade.
Yeah.
If my music teacher ever watches this, I had a huge crush on him, Michael Sir. I saw him from like these group of children just standing, and I just peeped like that, and I could see one man playing on the piano, and when he turned around, I just fell in love with him.
Yeah?
Yeah, Michael Sir.
Michael Jackson?
No, he was Michael Celis.
Your first love, crush?
You're looking for love.
Crush?
Huh? Crush would be... There was this one girl in school when I was like really young, might be 4 years old or something, and she was 8. So yeah, she was a...
Sweet.
I used to kind of meet her at tuitions or something.
Did you kiss her?
Oh, no. No way.
Quickly.
No way. I was too shy to do all that, yeah.
Okay, I'm going to ask both of you 3 words to describe each other.
Mm-hmm. I would say sincere, dedicated, spunky.
Spunky. Nice. Yeah. Oh, nice. I like that.
Yeah.
Immaculate.
Nice word.
Very driven towards his work. And very simple person.
Simple.
He's got no air, no stardom to himself, nothing.
Yeah. And one reason why everyone should watch Kar Le Pyar Kar Le. Or give me many reasons.
It stars Shiv and Hasleen, that's why. We're all newcomers. Not only the actors, the musicians, the technicians. So I feel the freshness is the USP. At the same time, it's really edgy and spunky. Yeah. So I think this is a good reason to kind of watch it.
Yeah.
I remember when we had the music launch.
Good music, yeah.
When we had the music launch and we had Mr. Mahesh Bhatt, he'd come and he saw the trailer and he said it looks very larger than life.
Yeah.
You know, everything in the film, the action, to the song sequences where we've gone, we've shot in some of the most beautiful locations of Thailand. So everything in the film is very larger than life. I think the action stunts that have been performed by Shiv, our action team, our musicians, our music, everything is worth a watch. It's less than 2 hours, it's worth a watch. It's just going to keep you grasped.
Yeah. Are you a trained martial artist?
No, I'm no way. I'm like a trained gymnast, but not. I've never done any action training as such.
Yeah.
I did action training on set.
Yeah, so you were gym buddies?
While shooting, we used to work out together. Yeah. We had very little time window, so 1 hour we used to go together.
Yeah, and like Mr. Mahesh Bhatt said, the movie is larger than life. Even the stars of the movie are taller than life.
Yes.
Larger than life. Yeah.
Like towering over everyone.
But Shiv, Hasleen, thank you very much and all the best. And I'm sure the movie is going to rock because
all
newcomers.
Thanks,
thank you so much.
Thanks.